I am really looking forward to these COD history videos. I do one every Wednesday and Sunday now, and it's different than the old series. This is where I do my picks, and I've done this video in the past, but it was community-driven. Today, I'm going to give you guys my personal list, and pistols have been in Call of Duty since the beginning, but they have definitely evolved from the early days. Up until Modern Warfare 2, the pistols in Call of Duty have just been simple sidearms for you to get a couple extra shots in before you reload, and they were never really anything super special, with a couple exceptions. But starting around MW2, the COD developers started having a bit more fun with the sidearms available to the player, and a lot of them ended up being arguably better than primary weapons. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today on COD History, we're going to be looking over my picks for the 10 best pistols in the Call of Duty franchise. And be sure to let me know which one is your favorite, and let's get into it. At number 10, and this is going to seem like a little bit of a bizarre pick, but I'm going to go with it. It's my list. I'm just going to do it. The Rift E9 in Black Ops 3. Now, this was a DLC weapon from BO3, and it's really where Call of Duty started getting kind of goofy with the emotes and the over-the-top weapons, and the Rift E9 was one of the first ones to be added. This weapon was added to supply drops and is one of the few guns in COD history to actually be a projectile instead of hit scan weapon, meaning you have to lead your shots with this thing. It's a 2-round burst pistol, but it's a 2-shot kill, meaning if you can instantly melt people with a single pull of a trigger, if you're accurate enough. This thing was also extremely good at taking down kill streaks, and it was able to destroy most airbase streaks with just a couple shots. I think it's a good way to kick off this list, and I don't know if people saw this one coming. At number 9, we're going to go back, man, and all I can say is freaking C-Nanners in his Rafika nuke. At number 9, the M93 Rafika in Modern Warfare 2. Now, MW2 was crazy with weapons. I mean, everything. Weapons, maps, killstreaks. But the M93 Rafikas were also insane, even by Modern Warfare 2 standards. These 3-round burst pistols were extremely powerful and were basically just a pocket version of the M16 from COD 4, especially with stopping power equipped. And you could equip two of them. You could akimbo these. There were tons of people who would run around with these babies as their primary weapon and drop nukes with them. And there's just something fun about a 3-round burst pistol in Call of Duty, and the Rafikas are where it all started. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 8, we have the 5.7 in Black Ops 2. This fan-favorite pistol was really nothing special statistically speaking, but its ease of use and its versatility is what made it a super common pick. The 5.7 was a very standard pistol with low damage and a pretty big magazine, but what made this thing so popular was the fact you could spray this thing like crazy, and if you had a good trigger finger, I mean, it was great. There was virtually no recoil to deal with. Plus, with the right attachments, you could bring it up to a freaking 27-round mag. I mean, and be fair, the 5.7 was capable of a 2-shot kill at point-blank range, but that's not really where it shined. It shined because it was an extremely reliable and easy-to-use weapon that rewarded players for good accuracy, which is why people flocked to it. Let's stick with Black Ops 2. There was a lot of pistols in Black Ops 2 that were really good. The TAC-45. Now, there was a pretty big rivalry in Black Ops 2 between the 5.7 and the TAC-45, so you let me know in the comments which one is better. On one hand, the 5.7 was very easy to use and spammable, but on the other hand, if you had the TAC-45, it was much more precise as a weapon and it hit like a truck. The TAC was a 10-round pistol with a very high damage, although it didn't really look like anything special on the surface. This baby would deal a whopping 55 damage up close, and it had a pretty generous range, making it capable of 2-3 shot kills from pretty insane distances. While it wasn't nearly as spammable or easy to use as its counterpart, the 5.7, the TAC-45 was a fan favorite because of its sheer stopping power, and it's definitely deserving of a spot on this list. I really liked this gun. Okay, and I know we're going to get some flack here because this, you're going to say, Jimmy, this has to be at the top of the list. But no, not on my personal list. The Cat-40 in Black Ops 2. Now, like I said, Black Ops 2 had some of the best pistols ever. The Cat-40 was a monster. I mean, it was essentially a pocket SMG. I mean, it was. The Cat 40 was a fully automatic pistol with a 15-round magazine that could deal up to 45 damage up close, and while you were burning through those 15 rounds pretty quickly, it was worthy. It was worthy of a spot on your class due to how quickly you could melt people. Extended clip would bring your magazine up to 20, and if you put on dual wield, your minimum damage would actually go from 19 to 24, which just made it even more of a melt machine. I mean, let me know, what were your favorite attachments to throw on the Cat 40? People were running around with this, they didn't even put a primary. We had pick 10, we had the credit class, and this is really where it started, where people would just run around with pistols with no primary, and they would just up all their perks and attachments. Okay, cracking into the top 5, the 44 mag in Modern Warfare 3. Now, revolvers are some of the best weapons you'll ever use in video games, and there have been some great ones in COD history. One of the best ones, to me, is the Modern Warfare 3 44 Magnum. While statistically speaking, it was weaker than the Modern Warfare 2 version, but it was still a monster due to the changes in the games overall, as well as the change in the firing sound. The Modern Warfare 3 version of the 44 mag would hit for 49 damage up close with a 1.4 times headshot multiplier, making it capable of a two-shot kill. Plus, part of what made this gun so deadly was the fact that it actually had multipliers beyond the head. Shots to the chest would also deal 1.4 times damage, and shots to the stomach would deal 1.1 times, meaning that you could pretty much hit somebody anywhere above the waist for a two-shot kill. This is probably one of the underappreciated pistols in the Call of Duty franchise. This thing was a beast. At number 4, we have the RK5 in Black Ops 3. Now, Black Ops 3 did its best to pay homage to the previous Black Ops games, and one of the ways they did that was bringing back the B23R in the form of the RK5. Now, people debated for hours which was better, the RK5 or the B23R. I'll let you guys decide yourself, but regardless of what you think, I'm putting these babies at number 4 because I feel like they deserve it. The RK5 was a 3-round burst pistol that would deal a maximum of 35 damage, meaning you could easily one burst people up close. And what's interesting is that when you look at the numbers of the RK5 in comparison to the other pistols in Black Ops 3, it's not that impressive. In fact, the MR6 pistol beats it out in terms of damage, range, and accuracy. But with that being said, people flocked to the RK5 due to how strong it was up close and just how good it felt to one burst somebody with a pistol, which is why I loved it. At number 3, I'm going to go with the Python in Black Ops. Definitely, to me, the best revolver in COD history, and this was great. The Python was a 6-round revolver that could deal up to 50 damage to the body, making it easy to pop people for a 2-shot kill. Plus, you had that speed reloader attachment that just made you feel like a total beast on the battlefield. Some of the best animations I've ever seen for reloading. The Python is also the only pistol in the game that is always a 1-shot kill in hardcore, and it has by far the best penetration of the entire pistol class. It was a monster in every aspect. There's no better way to say it. At number 2, I'm going to go with the Deagle, but specifically the Deagle from COD 4. Speaking of monsters, this is where crazy COD pistols really started. Like I said in the beginning of the video, pistols were mainly just for a last resort, weak shot deal if you ran out of ammo with your starting weapon, but the exception to the rule was the Deagle. This was the first time a pistol really became a threatening weapon from the enemy's perspective. The COD 4 Deagle would deal 50 damage to the body up close, and that's not even factoring in stopping power, meaning the Deagle would still be a 2-shot kill without using stopping power, and it was always a 1-shot kill in hardcore. Also, despite its ridiculous recoil, the Deagle had the best hipfire accuracy of any pistol in the game. And then on top of all that, the cherry on top of the sundae, you had perhaps the best firing sound in COD history when you pulled the trigger. To me, it deserves a number 2 spot today. Now, even though this is my personal list, this isn't going to shock anybody, and I honestly couldn't do it justice if I didn't put it at number 1. I mean, it really is the best. The B23R from Black Ops 2. Arguably, the most overpowered pistol ever in the game. Some would say this was one of the most overpowered guns overall. This 3-round burst pistol truly was a pocket M16, as it was able to deal up to 45 damage to the body, and while it didn't actually have any additional headshot multipliers, it didn't matter. It was still more than capable of dropping people with one pull of the trigger. Much like the RK5 in Black Ops 3, the B23R really doesn't have super impressive stats compared to other pistols, but there was just something about it where it all came together in the best way. So despite it being beaten out by the 5.7 and the TAC-45 in terms of accuracy and damage per bullet, the B23R was hands down the best pistol in the game due to how quickly it melted at close range and how much fun it was to run around with it as your primary and delete people. I remember being in a match to this day. I remember this match. somebody on the other team was running around with the B23R loadout. He didn't have a primary weapon. And I remember him dropping 102 kills on my team on Meltdown. I still remember that to this day. And there you have it, my friends. That is my personal list for the 10 best pistols in COD history. If you'd like to see my personal list for the 10 worst pistols, I can come up with that as well. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like. Let me know, what was your favorite go-to pistol of all time in COD history? Make sure you're subscribed and turn on those notifications so you never miss an upload. I'll see you guys Sunday for a new one.